Multiplying matrices and vectors using NumPy can be performed using the dot function. To demonstrate this function, we will create a new script with NumPy library imported as np. Next, we will create two new arrays, a and b, by calling the np.arrange function. We will pass in the integer 3 as the first argument in the arrange function for array a, and pass in 3, 6 for array b. We will print these both to the console to see that the A array has one row with the elements 0, 1, and 2, and array B has one row with the elements 3, 4, and 5. Now we will add another print statement, and within it, we will call the np.dot function. The first two arguments of the dot function are the two arrays we would like to multiply together. We will add array A as the first argument, and array B as the second argument. When the script is run, we will see the result of the dot product function is 14. This is because when the function is called on two arrays that are both one-dimensional, the result is a scalar representing the inner product of the two vectors. The inner product of the two vectors works by transforming the second array's shape into a single column. Next, the first value in array A, in this case 0, is multiplied by the first value in array B, in this case 3. Then this product is added to the product of the second value in array A and the second value in array B. This is repeated until the length of the first vector is reached. As you can see, the two arrays passed to the dot function must have the same length to perform this operation. When each of these products are added together, we get the result 14, which is the value that was printed to the console by the dot function. When the dot function is used on arrays with multiple dimensions, the dot product, or matrix multiplication, is performed. We will modify our existing arrays by changing the value within the arrange function to 12 for both array A and array B. Then we will chain on the reshape function after arrange and place the values 4 and 3 for array A and the values 3 and 4 for array B as arguments with each reshape function. The result arrays are two-dimensional, with array A having 4 rows and 3 columns, and array B having 3 rows and 4 columns. The shape of each of these arrays is intentional because we need the number of columns in the first array A to match the number of rows in the second array B to properly perform the dot product or matrix multiplication on two arrays. When we print the result of the dot function containing our two arrays to the console, we see the result is an array with 3 rows and 4 columns. When the dot product is performed, the first row of array A is multiplied by the first column of array B, one element at a time. The product of all of these elements is added to create the resulting value of 20, which is located in the first row, first column of the resulting array. This process is then repeated by multiplying the first row of array A with the second column of array B, and so on. If you're using Python 3.5 or newer, there is a shorthand version of performing the dot product or matrix multiplication between two-dimensional arrays. Instead of using the dot function, we can place an at symbol in between the two arrays we would like to multiply. When we print the result to the console, we see the array is exactly the same as when we use the dot function. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.